iHanna, and I'm here with a little video on tiny journals again. And this one is some journals that I have that is going to be for sale in March, and then continuing on in April because I'm doing it in the end of March. So I've got my coffee, and I got thinking about this because, so before I get too much into the video, I want to add it in here that newsletter subscribers get a first glimpse of this video and notification that these are in the shop. So if you're a newsletter subscriber, hurry up before I release it to the blog and this video gets shown on YouTube so that others can also get in on grabbing one of these. So that's the one thing I wanted to say. And also my shop is on my blog, so if you go up and you'll find in the description bar a little thing that says shop, and there I'll always list my my things. So I had a release in January of Traveler's Notebooks junk journals, and they sold really well. And in February I just got caught up with other things and didn't notice it was a short month, so I didn't get to do any journal releases. So that's what we're doing today. And if you think I talk too much about these, and this video is quite long because I want to talk to them, I want to keep them in video format for myself. I love looking through things like this myself. I will also post a quick video of these same journals showing other pages with a bit of music. So this is the long version of the video. So if you're in a hurry, or you don't want to listen to me have my coffee and talk about journals, then skip this one and go to the video with music. But in any case, let's get into the nitty gritty. So I've got my coffee, and I got thinking about this because Tam and I are doing a little project that is called Fill a Tiny Journal. And I've done a couple of videos. I filmed my first spread on and how I did this page, and then we're sharing on Instagram and our blogs. And this is the second page that you have seen on the blog that is on the prompt connection. But that's not what we're talking about today, and Tammy made this. And so I got thinking about my little box of tiny journals, and these are just some of the journals that I have made or collected through the years. And let's see, these ones, how many ever they are ones that I made to sell once upon a time. It was many years ago, so I'm gonna see. This one is one of those. I'm calling them wee books. And I put labels on them, and they're full of collage. They're really small. They're a lot smaller than my tiny journal that I'm working in. And I loved making them. But then I haven't made any more because these are just sitting here and nobody's loving on them. So oh, this is one. That's another kind. This is a super cute book that I got in a swap once. And this one as well, I think. It's not what one that I made. Tiny journal that I worked in for a while. This is a bought journal and never used. And since it's been in this box, of course it's not being used. I need to put this in my handbag and fill it with doodles of 2021. I think I'll do that. It's so cute and perfect size to bring out now that it's beginning to look a lot like spring around here. This one I made in 2010. And I have a blog post on this one talking about how I made it and showing all the pages. So I don't need to do that on video. So these are staying. Or have I started using this one? No, I have not. So that might go to the sale. And this one is a collection of different quotes that I've saved. So that's ongoing. Yeah. Moving this to the side. I do not even remember. It's a lot of years since I made these. All of them have the labels and they have a special name. So that's what I'm listing them under. And they're kind of done. Like you could just keep them and put them on a shelf and look through them as inspiration, or you can add in your own stuff. It's totally up to you. The listing will be for these 5 books plus 3 extras that I'm going to be listing. I've taken 2 of them aside. This one doesn't have a label, and this one I've started working in and done some writing in and such. So I thought I'd just keep those. Plus this has my handmade beads on it, and those are precious to me, so I want to keep them, even though I should make more, and I probably have some more somewhere. But on the rest of them, they have all kind of different cute beads. So you'll get to pick one, and each of these are called Wee Book, and it has a subtitle as well. So we're going to go through them and just have a look at how cute they are. That's what we're doing today. I'm gonna start with, which one should I start with? Let's just start with the first one in the pile. This one is called Like a Soft Kiss, which is more thinking of the soft colors in it more than kisses. But I thought it was a sweet name, so I guess I named it that. And it's been more than 5 years, I checked, and I have made so many journals since I made these. So I'm not sad if you are wanting one for yourself. This one, Like a Soft Kiss, starts out with an image of a porcelain figurine, and then it has like collage and different kind of papers on all the pages. So they're kind of like junk journals. Well, of course they are like junk journals, and whether you like to keep them as they are or you want to add in your own stickers and ephemera and stuff, or maybe do some journaling, pages like this will lend themselves well to do some journaling or just add in little poems. That's what I wanted to do with the fill a tiny journal project, was to fill it with poetry. And then at the second prompt, I forgot about it, so I didn't write anything, even though it has words. Yeah, so we'll see if I, by next week, or this week actually, will remember to add in some words, some strings of words that create a little poem. This is from the Barbie magazine, and a sticker, and these pretty flowers. And they're a little bit battered up because they've been in this box for a long time. But I think they're so darling, and I love all the pages. And this is a bunny in a pink car. Who doesn't like that? And I've sewn a lot on the pages, and I left strings sticking out because I like the look of that. Here's a cozy spot with some cushions. Part of a butterfly, part of a bird, and some room for adding in something. I think this is a stamped with paint. And this is a piece of a wallpaper, actually. And an envelope, I guess. Brown envelope. Some tape, needle. Lotus flower, very harmonious, very soft, like a kiss. And then it's the blue paper that is the cover. I didn't add anything to the back of this one. So that's absolutely, you can add in anything. I will add in. I'm just going to finish it off by adding in a label that says it's made by me, in case down the road you want to remember who you got it from. That's my thinking. And it also says on the front, by iHanna, handmade with love by iHanna, we book for creative adventures. And there's a butterfly there, and some sparkles on a pink cotton string. So cute. So this is like a soft kiss. This one is called Window of the Soul. It has an eye and a butterfly and a little flower and some sparkly beads. So it starts off with a wallpaper that I spray painted on. Is this a pocket or not? I'm not sure. I don't think so. Maybe it's a secret compartment. So this is also done with the very soft and sweet colors. I was into that at this time. And I've added in a label from a tea that I was drinking. Some beautiful flowers and a stamp from, I guess it's a Chinese stamp that is upside down. And this says the world's best anti-stress trick is a meditated walk in the woods for relaxation and focus, in Swedish. Cute little girl with a doll. A scrap piece of paper with gold doodles or print. I don't remember. More butterflies. Tying together with the butterfly on the little string. This is like a place for journaling, and it's sticking out, and you can fold it in if you want to, but you can also do like a little note on of what you wrote here. And little grasshoppers in their different stages of development. No, they're not grasshoppers. They are, because grasshoppers are not born in the sea. They are dragonflies. Sorry. And then it climbs up and becomes a beautiful dragonfly, I think. More stamps from Japan. This forest again, with some birds sitting in the branches, and a horse. A grasshopper that is not a dragonfly. Window with a bird. This spray painted wallpaper. I love this. I loved doing this with my friend when we were having like a spray day of just decorating. And a cozy bedside table. There's a stamp on the back, because I think stamps are like the perfect thing for wee little books. So that's window of the soul. Then we have Boys Are Silly Cute, a wee book for creative adventures with a black and white cover. And yeah, I will add in the labels later on. This one has just a tiny little dangle and a green flower that corresponds with this green flower on the cushion. And lots of sewing all around the page. It starts off with some marbles and a kid's toy rocket. Some boys playing around in the yard. Troll by a Swedish artist, Jon Bauer. And a Barbie and her purple castle and lots of cute flowers and a butterfly. And a frog. I love frogs. And if you don't want a Barbie in your book and you're getting this one, just glue like a paper here that you can journal on or anything. I'd keep the castle at least because I think it's cute, but it's totally up to you. And it would also be perfect, you know how you do, like you can add in little strips of paper on top on any of these pages and like write a little poem on top of those, like this. Just glue in or use blank tape, like painter's tape or something that you can write on. That's always an option if you can't find a waterproof pen that you can write on the blank magazine pages. More mischievous boys, I think. And that's where this book got its title, Boys Are Silly Cute. The Maid. Oh, these are so sweet. Here's another boy, but he's gone a little bit further in his adventures. From 69. And last boy picture, I think. And a heart, because we like boys. If they're nice, even though they are often silly. No, more boy pictures. A David Thoreau quote, "My life is like a stroll upon the beach, as near to the ocean's edge as I can go." And isn't that very much a boy thing to say? I think so. And I mean boys in a general way of all of us that are adventurous. So, and animal boys, some coffee, Higgly Piggly Pop, and the end of Boys Are Silly Cute. I don't know why I named it Boys Are Silly Cute, but there's a lot of boys in this one. So if you have a boy, or if you like boys in any way, or if you are a boy, maybe, get this one. This is called Vanilla Romance. Doesn't that sound sweet? It has a homemade clay bead, as well as a pink bow and some plastic beads. Some tape that is looking like lace. And a red cover with a super romantic flower image. So that's Handmade with Love by iHanna. Wee book for creative adventure. Vanilla style. So, vanilla colored pages. Both of these are wallpapers that I have on the row, so I really like them. Tulips and roses and a label for you to write something. And then we have birds, patterns, this owl. More pages that has more room for a focal image or some writing. Indian woman who likes to drink vanilla tea, I think. This Swedish text says samlarnas hämningar av ögongodis, which means kind of a collector's home is filled or heavy with eye candy. Ögongodis, eye candy. So that's that. Just some random images that I liked and wanted to glue down and put into this book. I love putting like different patterns together like that. And sewing, lots of sewing, adding in pattern. This is a copy of a collage I made. This is a copy of a fabric I have. And this is a flower from the vanilla plant. So that's probably where this book got its name, Vanilla Romance. There's always like something or an idea that gets started, and then lots of vanilla colors and just the regular feel of that. And this has a brand and a little bit of ribbon attached to the back, but it's covered with tape. So that's this one. Super cute little book. I'm adding it to the pile that's going into the shop. And this is the last one that I'm going to show you in this video because it's long. Handmade with Love Wee Book Journey Ahead. So it has yellow and different kind of beads and this green flower. And a copy of a rose paper, this plastic ribbon, or is it color ribbon when it's like what you had used to decorate packages. Anyway, I sewed it down because I loved the colors of this one. Very, very bright pink. And I used a turquoise thread to add it in. So it starts off with random images, windows that are upside down, a little door handle, and these white balloons on white background that I think is so lovely and just feels like you're floating in the air. I like it. There's a map of a subway and super cute daisy paper. Open up your head and think about that. I guess this image is. And just cuteness. This is a copy of an owl that I drew. Also a long time ago, and I made so many copies. I still have some of that drawing. And the middle is from a book that I used to tear out the pages for, and I just think it's so cute. That little, I think it's a reindeer. Perhaps not. This says making, and then we have a quote to the side that says, writing is my refuge. It is where I go. It is where I find that integrity I have. By Mr. Charles B. Johnson. And then we have Charlie and his puppy. And the journey planner where I got the subway maps is from London Underground. And on the underground subway map, I added another. This is a doodle of a bird that I added in. Daisies. more balloons, and I've already added the label to this one. And then it's finished. So I'm just going to be gluing this down a little better. Like so. So that it doesn't move around. And I have no idea if anyone wants these. So that's an experiment. I don't understand why anyone would want them. But I love them. I do. I'm listing these. And you can pop on over to the shop and see what I have there. I have some digital stuff and a book I wrote. So if you're not into tiny journals that are almost filled, you can still go and check it out. And I will also be adding these three journals. This is made in the same way. It has a purple cover, but it's not filled. It's just wallpaper. So you can use it to paint acrylics or do collages or anything. So I will add this one in. This one has a hard cover, but it has brown paper in and rounded corners. I love that. So it's super cute. It's one of my paintings on the front and a sticker that says made by iHanna and an owl. And this one, it has a beautiful vintage wallpaper cover. No beads at the side, so you can just cut off this little string. And inside it has just grid paper. So it would be perfect for a tiny bullet journal or any kind of scribbles or whatever you want to do in a tiny journal. It has this envelope and inside that is empty, and I'll add in a little label that I made it, but otherwise that's it. You get a bonus image on the first page of this super cute scrap die cut cat. So those are the three bonus journals, and I want to say thank you for watching, thank you for checking out my shop, and I have leave any comments or suggestions. Do you have any favorites of these? Which one do you like? I would love to know. Thank you so much. Take care and stay crazy.